Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Theo here. On today's video, we are going to actually see if an oil catch can is worth it on a Mini Cooper S right behind me. Follow me. Before I start the video, I want to make sure one thing. Please make sure that you subscribe to the channel, like this video if you like this type of content. On this channel, I have a F80 BMW M3, E36 BMW M3, and I also have this Mini Cooper S. Yes, I work on all these cars myself, and I try to vlog about them, you know, go to shows and all type of fun stuff. Go to my channel, you will see what I've done so far, and I have so many plans for the future. Now let's go to the topic at hand. Now, I installed this oil catch can, I think 2 or 3 months ago, and so far I haven't removed it to see if there's any oil buildup in there. So that's exactly what we're going to do today, to know if this is actually worth spending your money on buying that. Let's go ahead and check it out. Here is the oil catch can that I installed recently, as I mentioned. Now, pretty much the installation is simple. I'm going to go ahead and drop a link up there so you can see the video for the installation. I also provide a quick review on why you need the oil catch can for your Mini Cooper S, especially if you have the N14 engine. Now, since I did the installation, I did not even check the level. I did not do anything. I just, you know, kept driving the car. So let's go ahead and first time see the oil level. Now, this specific oil catch can comes with this dipstick where you can remove it to see the level. Now, it's kind of hard to see the level when it is in red right here. Can't really see too much. So what I'm going to do is actually just open the bottom part, which is this part right here, and just see if I have any oil build up there. Now, normally I can do this by just putting my hands here and squeezing, but because it is a little tight here, I want to use both of my hands to kind of do it really quick. So I'm not going to film how I'm removing it. So it's pretty much me doing this right here and moving it counterclockwise. Let me go ahead and remove it really quick. All right guys, so I went ahead and removed. Because it was a little challenging to remove, so I actually did unscrew the whole bracket to kind of have an easy access to unscrew the whole thing. And this is what I found out inside. As you can see, the baffle portion seems like drop in the bottom here, and I have a little bit of oil. Now, this oil residue right here was supposed to go in my engine if I did not have this oil catch can. So this one shows you that the oil catch can works, and if you have an N14 or N18 Mini Cooper S, you definitely need this mod ASAP, because this is exactly going to avoid you having carbon buildup on your pistons and all of that area right there. So let me go ahead and trash this, fix this baffle portion on the top right here, and then screw everything back up. I went ahead and mounted everything back together. If I was not filming, this whole job would have, you know, taken me only like 5 minutes, but because I'm filming, I have to show you, explain everything. They took me maybe 15 minutes to do this job, including filming. So that just shows you how easy it is to kind of check the level and also remove the reservoir and kind of dump it so that you have a fresh, clean interior on the oil catch can. Now again, if you want to know about the installation of the oil catch can, I dropped a link or a video earlier, so go ahead and click that so you can watch the installation. It is very simple, but yet it can help you a lot to keep your engine in check. So that's it for this video, and you can see that this oil catch can is very useful. So if you like this type of video, make sure that you comment, leave a like, and also subscribe so that you can see what I turned out this Mini Cooper to. This is going to be a great build. As you can see, I already started working on the engine, so the work is not completed. Make sure that you subscribe so you can see what's happening. Again, my name is Theo. Thank you for watching my channel. Bye bye.